Hey you and welcome. I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students. See, I'm going to rename this file sequence named comp, starting from the very first file there to the new name. I'm going to do it all in one shot. Let me show you how I did this. Okay, open up the folder that has your files in it. And if you don't see your file extensions, go up here to the file, go on to options, and then click on view. And then where it says hide extensions for known file types, go ahead and click that so it doesn't have the checkup mark anymore. Apply, and now we'll see the file extensions on these. Now we need to copy the file path. Click up here and notice it shows it up here in the address box. Right click it and copy. Now you want to open up your browser. It doesn't matter which browser you're using. Go up to the URL address box and right click and paste. Then hit the enter key once and you'll see this displayed here. Copy all of these by using the shortcut Control A. This highlights them, and then Control C will copy everything. Now you need to open up Microsoft Excel or any spreadsheet app. Now once Excel opens up, go ahead and paste it in. You can use the shortcut Control V to paste all the data in there. What we need to do is we need to see the title. So go up here to the column here and spread it out. So now we can clearly see the title name of each file. And since we only need the file names, what you could do is highlight all the other areas and hit the delete key, and it will delete your other data there that we don't need. There you go. So now we have just the file names listed here. Okay, now click on the H there to highlight the column that has your titles in it, and we need to copy that. You could use Control C to copy it, and you'll see these little ants going around that. Now we need to copy them over to the C column, or the I column here. And once we highlight the I column, go over here, click on this arrow under paste, and choose paste values. Now we have the names without the hyperlinks. And the reason why we do this is because when you copy over from the browser, it copies with your hyperlink. All right, we can delete this column altogether. So I'll go H is deleted there. Now I'm going to highlight all this, copy it, and I'm going to go over to column C here and use Control V to paste it in. There we go. Now we have all the titles in column C. Click in the very first A1, key in rename. In column B, put one space in there, and that's important for the command. In D, leave one space in there, and then click in E1. So now in E, we're going to type in the new name that I want these. So we're going to call these that work. And then underscore 001. And then for the F, you want to have the file extension. So notice it's .m4v, so that has to be there. .m4v has to be the same extension. Now click in the middle of A1, drag it across, and see this little box here? Click on the little black box and drag it straight down. And now you notice it's copied it all the way down. And same for column D, just drag that down. And now you need to copy these two, Control C and then Control V. That way we have that pasted over. Now what we need to do is we need to give it the next number. So key in for 002 for the second one there. Now highlight all of these here like this, 1 and 2, and drag both of these down. There you go, and you notice each one has the number in order, 1 through 14. Now click into column G, and we're going to type in equal sign, and then C-O-N for concatenate. And now go into A1, click it there, and then put the comma, and then we need B1, comma, C1, comma, D1, comma, and then there's the all important file name, comma, and F1. Now you'll notice it says rename comp35.m4v to that work underscore 001. What we want to do is we want to highlight this one here and drag it down. There you go. Now you notice each one changes according to the file name that we have. Now we need to copy all these names here by going Control C, and it becomes highlighted there. Now you need to open up Notepad and paste that contents right there into Notepad. And this is why we had the single spaces there in Excel, is to add these spaces here for my commands. Now we need to save this in the same location as our media files are located, and that's right here into the animated media files. And we need to rename this to underscore cmd.cmd and then click on save. Now open up the folder that has the files in it, and you'll notice the very first one there has underscore cmd.cmd. Go ahead and click it, and it changes all of the names for you there. And it's that easy. So now you know how to change a long list of file names from one type there to another, all in one shot. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below if you have a question, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.